Hello everyone, this is gonna be a quick guide on how to play Naga Siren. This here got actually requested on Reddit. I got a private message. Someone asked me if I could do a Naga guide and I forgot your name, but if you watch it, I hope you like it. So basically, your starting items should usually look like this. That's how I mostly start my games. If you play against a hero that spams a lot of spells like Batrider or Bristleback, for example, you could get a stick first and don't buy slippers. But usually I start like this, and starting the game, the runes. So you scale your illusions level 1, like almost, actually you do it every time. And a good trick is you pop your illusions before the rune spawns on the high ground, and then you send one illusion back and walk in with all three. Like sometimes they just ignore that illusions are at the rune and try to fight you or chase you or something, and then you just chase them with your illusions and hit them while your real hero is in between and doing actually some damage. So you could get a good trade in the rune fight. I would not do it if the enemy is like a high kill potential or is there with 3 or 4 heroes, then just don't do it and ignore the rune. On itemization, I would go with double Wraith Band. You could go triple Wraith Band, but double is actually fine. Should definitely get power treads and a wind lace, and you should try to keep this wind lace as long as possible. It makes your hero faster, your illusions faster. It's just overall a very valuable item on this hero. And after your small starting items, you can have a stick if you play against a lane that has a lot of spells to spam. If not, I would recommend skip the stick. So on laning stage is kinda simple. You want to max out your mirror image first and then always scale Riptide with it. Don't scale Net, or you could scale Song at level 6, but usually you kinda want to be more greedy and farm more, so I don't usually scale in like 95% of my games. I mean, the only situation I would skill Song of Siren is if I just hit level 6 and I get ganked and I can use Song to save myself. On itemization, I would go with a Yasha. You could buy drums. Drums is okay, but they got nerfed now in the last patch, so I'm not sure about drums on Naga anymore. Maybe the casual windlass is just enough, but definitely go the Yasha Diffusion Blade Manta combo. You could buy a Manta first if you needed to dispel something like a silence or anything else. Otherwise, definitely get the Diffusion first. It ups your kill potential a lot and your damage output with all your illusions. After that, I usually buy either Basher or Skadi, depending on if you need more survivability. You should go for Skadi. If you want the lockdown from Bash, you can go Bash. Kinda depends on the game. Like if I would play against the Void, for example, I would probably get the Skadi instead of the Basher. Depends on how the game looks, but the Skadi just makes you more tanky, so it's more likely to survive during the Chrono if you get caught. After that, so let's say you bought Bash, you could upgrade it to Abyssal Blade to lock down even more if you play against very elusive heroes like Storm, Ember, for example. Otherwise, you could buy Butterfly or Satanic or maybe a Hex. Like, it just depends on how the game goes. If you want more lockdown, you can go the Hex route. If you want to be more survivable, you can buy Satanic or Heart. They're all pretty good items. So from neutral items, try to get the Iron Talon and a royal jelly combo. Like, this is basically your dream. It's unlikely to have it, but if you get it, definitely go for Iron Talon jelly. If you not get it, you can get Pullman Shield, or the Ironwood Tree is pretty good. Broomhandle is okay. Ocean Art is mediocre. The Feather Brooch is actually also pretty good because of the movement speed. So kind of basically almost all the tier 1 items are pretty good on Naga Siren. For tier 2 items, you want the Vembrace the most, or Ring of Aquila, like either one of those. If you can't get it, you can get Dragon Scale or Imclaw, also good items, or the Pupit's Gift, or like I like to call it, the Apple, if you want to be more tanky. Tier 3 items are not that interesting. Titan Sliver is okay, but if you don't get a Titan Sliver, it's also not the end of the world. You could get Orb of Destruction. The Paladin Sword is mediocre on your hero. It's not that important, and the rest is sort of just kind of meh. But tier 4 items, yeah, it kind of gets interesting. I would say Illusion Escape is definitely the best jungle item or neutral item you can get on your hero, except from tier 5 items. Not only it gives you like good stats, you get more HP and more damage, you can get this extra illusion, and all your other illusions deal this 10% more damage, the passive of the Illusion Escape. If you don't get Illusion Escape, you can get Ninja Gear to pick off people and be just more mobile and more agility. Or the leveler, if you the leveler is just overall a good item on your hero. Could get Minotaur Horn too for the mini BKB. Kind of depends. If you have Illusion Escape, you should definitely pick it up and use it. Maybe something interesting can be in how to actually use all of your illusions. Like, you will have a lot of units to control. I have it set up like this. If I press my mirror image, I have one hotkey where I have my Naga and one illusion. I have another hotkey where I have two illusions from mirror image. And that's how you kind of farm in the early game. Like, you have this split up into two, and you send your Naga and your illusion to the stronger camp, and your bow and your two illusions to a weaker camp, and just farm the jungle like this. And of course, for Manta, I have an extra hotkey for my Manta illusions, and for the Illusion Escape, I also have a hotkey. And then you can go into your options as well, and you can use this, select all controlled units. This basically, like it says, it selects all the units you have controlled right now. So if you want to go on someone, you have all your illusions, you just press this one button and click on him. So every illusion and your hero hits the hero you want to hit. Or if you just want to send your your illusion in, you can use select all other units, so all your illusions will maybe hit a tower or something, and you just want to stay back and don't want to hit it with your normal hero. For talents, I would go level 10 with the movement speed, definitely. It just movement speed is just way too good on your hero to skip it. Level 15, in 95% of my games, I take strength just to be more survivable. You usually do a lot of damage during a level 15 timing. Then you have your diffuser, your manta. You're pretty good with damage, and so you don't need the extra agility. Level 20 is an okay talent if you take mirror illusion, but the 9-second ensnare cooldown just makes it basically permanently. It is 5% uptime and how long cooldown? 14 seconds. So with your minus 9, it's literally up all the time. And on level 25, evasion is okay, but it's so late into the game, so most of your opponents will have an NKB or something to deal with evasion. So I would recommend take Riptide Armor, need the minus 5 Riptide Armor. But it's up to you what you prefer. And in some games, let's say you're playing against heroes that don't usually buy MKB or no one has an MKB for some reason, you can go with the evasion talent and just be more tanky and harder to kill. Yeah, when you should pick Naga, or when does it indicate, oh, this is a good Naga game? I would pick Naga Siren if the enemies pick something like Undying first phase, or if they pick any heroes that have trouble clearing illusions. And of course, bad Naga Siren game would be if they pick a lot of AoE damage or AoE lockdown. Like Earthshaker, for example. It doesn't mean like it's unplayable, then I think a lot of people get this concept wrong. It's not like you pick Naga into Earthshaker and you insta lose. It just makes a bit more difficult to play around if the enemy has a lot of AoE lockdown. And in terms of carry matchups, Naga actually counters a lot of the common meta heroes that are played right now. Like for example, I see a lot of Drow Rangers. Naga is definitely very good against Drow Ranger. Naga is very good against Faceless Void. Naga is good to deal with Jug. Naga is okay to deal with Anti-Mage. It's not perfect, but it's also not the end of the world. Naga can deal with Spectre or TB. Did I miss anything? I don't think so. And I forgot to mention, of course Naga deals with the meta support heroes pretty well. Like Clockwork has basically no chance to kill Naga Siren in the early game. You can have your illusion into the cogs and it's pretty hard for him to get you. Also, if you're cogged, you can just use your illusions to get yourself free. Another meta for you would be, like I said, Undying struggles a lot to deal with Naga. Phoenix is also kinda countered by Naga Siren. You can just song and everyone can focus the egg and no one can help him if no one has a BKB then. So overall Naga is pretty strong in this patch right now. I think it's kinda undercover a bit and will probably most likely get another buff, or people will find out that the hero is actually pretty strong and played a lot. Like it's hard to tell. So I hope you enjoyed the guide, learned something, and if there are any more suggestions on what heroes or what role I should cover, so just send me a message on Reddit or write it on the YouTube comment section. So have a good day, good night whenever you watch it, and I hope you get some free points with this Naga guide.